What I'm admitting is I started a false rumor that there is a ghost in the pet hotel, and it caught on like wildfire. So what happened was, it was like 2 a.m. and I, like, every like hour, get up and like, and down the aisles, kind of look at the dogs and stuff. And I thought it would be a funny idea to take a picture and edit in a really, really realistic looking silhouette of a ghost. And I found a phone app and I did it that night. That's how I did it, guys. That's how I did it. That's how I fooled. God. And it looked real, and it looked really creepy. It was like you couldn't even tell that you could tell it was like slightly humanoid, and it looked like it was holding a lantern. But it looked real, dude. I kid you not. It looked real. And that morning, at like, I got off at 6 a.m., right? And that morning, the manager came in, and I was like, okay, play the part. Oh, my God. Oh, you're not going to do this. I've been shaking, like, freaking out, you know? Like, it's my acting skills. Universal, hire me. I was playing this part of being, like, terrified, and I was even, like, kind of faking my hand. I'm like, look at this picture, look at it. And my manager looked at it and was like, oh my God. And I'm like, do you see that? Do you see what, like, and she's like, yeah, what is that? And I was like, I was walking up and down the aisles and I looked down the hallway and the picture, I'm gonna have to find it and post it on Facebook for y'all to see, or post it, because it looks creepy.
God, need to and see this I, for sure.
Yeah, exactly. I was walking up and down the aisles, and I saw this weird silhouette next to the, like, it was like next to the brooms or something, you know? And I was looking at it, and I saw part of it move. And she was like, oh my God. And I was like, yeah. So I pulled out my phone and I took a picture of it, because I had my phone with me already, you know? And I looked at the picture, and it was in the picture, and then I looked, gone. And she's like, oh my God. and I was like having to work that night. Like, I'm obviously going to come back like quitting or anything, but this was really creepy and it's been weirding me out all night. And then I left and I let the managers talk and the employees talk. And I was there for 2 years. And I started this up kind of quick because I get bored. And I had everybody there. Like, dude, there was one manager that, like, I got in that night, or not that night, it was months later, and I got in that night and she grabbed my arm. She's like, I saw it. Geez. I saw it. And I'm like, no way. She's like, I saw it. I saw the lantern. And I'm just like, whoa. No, you didn't. But it was like, I mean, she probably thought she did. Like,
yeah, man, the mind can play tricks on people like that.
Yes. And I will say, when you're in the back, like that back hallway, and you guys obviously looks like, but that back hallway, it's creepy because it's quiet. We don't really book a lot of dogs back there unless we get really, really, really full. I like how I'm saying we, like I still work. But that place, there's not a whole lot of dogs there, and it's really quiet, and that's where I took the picture. So it's already like as far away from the front desk as you can get. So it's secluded, and it's really quiet, and it's eerie. And people were like not wanting to go in that back hallway.
So basically all the dogs stored back there did not get taken care of that well.
No. You're making me look like an apple. No, you're probably right. Like, I don't it's my fault.
I didn't get to feed Fluffy today. I was scared of the ghost.
And I'm just like, phone app. Like, that's what it was. So it was a free app too, you know, but I did that and it was great. It was awesome. So I am admitting it 10 years later that I started the ghost.
One of those listeners like, that dick, I didn't sleep that night.
It's actually kind of funny because I think one person that I worked with is going to end up listening. So
Sorry.